I want to pivot away from all this very important and high-minded talk and ask you a question directly. Why is Bunk Moreland the best character in the history of television? Mr. Pierce, I don't know if that was your creation or that you and David Simon worked on the contours of that character together, oh, yeah, or if the words were already on the page. But goodness gracious,
it was a combination.
Right.
I have to tip my hat to David Simon. He is the creator of the character. But there is a real Bunk in Baltimore.
Please tell the story.
Oscar Requeir. And I did my walk-alongs with him because at this point of his career, he was just in the courthouse.
Yep.
And oh, he regaled me with tales. And hey, Bunk, hey, and oh, he introduced me. I want you to meet. He's going to play me in HBO series.
Right?
Oh, very gregarious. So I picked that up. There were other detectives that I walked with, David's writing and all. But I'll never forget one moment, my first day of shooting. Bunk, the real Bunk, drove up in his caddy with his cigar going, and he got out in the distance, and he got out the car, he saw me working, and went, put his cigar back in his mouth, got in his car, and drove off, and I never called him again.
Is that right?
I was terrified.
Is that right?
I shot the show for 5 years going, oh, my God, this man is so embarrassed by what I'm doing on television.
Was the character based on him in the sense that the mannerisms and the pattern of speech and the way that he approached his job, or was there a McNulty character similarly based on somebody who worked with, how did this all go?
It was an amalgam because, first of all, I brought that to the character.
Of course, most, right. Anything that was awesome about it, I get it.
The sleight of hands, the gestures, the voice.
Right.
McNulty was really based on Ed Burns, our creator, co-creator with David Simon, who was a police officer turned teacher. So that Presbuluski was a part of him also.
Right.
And so Bunk was an amalgam. David, some of other detectives that I researched, and Oscar Requeir himself. And then at the end of the series, in the last season, someone saw me at a barber shop and said, you know, Bunk is retiring. You better be there. I went, oh, my goodness.
Really?
So I'm terrified. I go, and I see him across the room looking at me the same way. And so I walk there sheepishly, ready for my comeuppance. He looks at me and goes, hey, come here. You made me a star.
Really?
It was like the prodigal son coming on. Oh, that's me. Yeah, that's the guy. Yeah, that's me. This is TV Bunk. Yeah, I'm the real Bunk. I was actually on the dais. You know, I had to speak at the retirement. You know, I've known Bunk for three days, 5 years ago.
Does it concern you at all? Maybe concern is the wrong word. You know, it's sort of like being a musician, you had a hit 30 years ago.
Oh, no,
people walk down the street, they yell Allison
Bunk
and Elvis Costello.
Yeah, right.
Right, do they yell Bunk all the time at you?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Bunk, Bunk, Bunk. But listen, it's going to be the first line of my obituary. Wendell Pierce, who played Bunk Moreland on HBO.
Is that right?
Yes. Died at 110 today.
Hopefully. Oh, my God, right.
So I have no problem with it. You know, if it was Gilligan, it would be a different.
Right.
I feel for
high
Mr. Denver.
High art. High
you know?
Art.
Yeah.
Right.
So pick your choices wisely.
Bunk is not Gilligan. You know, the lesson of this is Bunk,
I mean,
is not,
you know,
Gilligan.
I'm not going around with a little sailor hat at conventions at 75, you know.
Signing autographs. Did you all know when you were making that show that it would be so disproportionately iconic? Anything else? I mean, I would argue before or since. People still talk about that as the absolute best show ever on television.
Yeah, we didn't know. It was a slow burn, I should say. I never forget seeing the first two episodes with Andre Royo and Sonia Son, who played Bubbles
and Kima. Yep.
And we watched the first two. Man, I hope you're saving your money, because this is going to be canceled.
Right.
That's the first thing we said. Right. That's the first thing I said.
Right.
And then the third season, we would shoot and then go away, and it would go on the air. And then we'd come back and say, wow, people are watching. We'll go. By the third season, we knew we had a cult-like following. We had to pitch the show every season at HBO.
To come back, is that
to
right?
To come back.
I didn't know that.
But
that's
David always has a final chapter in mind, and he saw it as the 5 years.
And that was it.
And that was it.